Venom. By dawn, she was lying soaked under the sweaty sheet she used for a blanket. For weeks now, she had been dreaming the same dream, exactly the same, day after day. She took off her nightshirt because it would have stuck to her body like an unpleasant cold poultice. Not because it was so hot, she was lucky. Her lodgings were on a plateau almost 800 meters above sea level, but not too far from the sea either, so she could still feel the salt in the air. The climate was pleasantly subtropical, one might say, for the state, and within it, the city, was cut in two by the Capricorn. Aqui passa o trópico de Capricórnio, she read on a signpost on an outing, as though by a freshly sharpened machete. No complaints, Kay thought, as she was lying there in sweat, because the city that she kept calling so to herself, for she would only call by its name that other one at home, really did everything it could to take her in, wound its pulsating, strong body in a tight embrace around Kay's wilting, decaying body like a sizable cobra, a jiboia, a common boa constrictor, or on jollier days, a colorful rainbow boa. It was pressing the air out of her, slowly, gradually, and every time its grip tightened a bit, she could hear the infamous boa belch, bafo da jiboia.